I'm at least back reporting. Strength and conditioning with Tolly Kaminsky, very original drill. You have a Russian heavyweight over here. David Kaminsky, national champion, only 16 years old. David, what's the name of the Russian heavyweight?
Who?
Right here.
Andrei Fedosov.
Andrei Fedosov. And look at right here, David Kaminsky. He's pushing a Jeep, only 16 years old, 10-time national champion. He's a national champ right now at 165. And look at that, that's pretty cool. Pretty badass. And now he's pushing the Jeep one more time. I feel bad for your next opponent. You're gonna punish him for making you work so hard.
Fuck yeah.
Fuck yeah, yeah. Can I sit in the Jeep while you pull it?
Go ahead.
All right, we're gonna get in the Jeep right now. Hold on. We're gonna see if he could pull it while we're sitting in it. All right, go ahead, we're in. I'm adding more resistance. This is 16 years old, David Kaminsky, national champion. He's working hard right now. Pulling the Jeep. Not bad. Ten-time national champ, only 16 years old. He sparred the likes of Postol. He sparred many champions, professional. He does great against them. You can follow him at Official David Kaminsky on the IG. He's going to Japan 2020. Maybe representing the United States, maybe representing Israel. But right now he's working with his dad. His dad is his trainer. This is what it takes to be a star. He already ran this morning. He worked in the gym later in the afternoon. And now it's almost 9 o'clock at night here in LA. He's working strength and conditioning. And you have Alim over here. He's all the way from Tajikistan, from Dushanbe.
That's right.
Putting in work, but he lost his Russian accent. I don't know how he did it in 6 months. And who's this in front of us?
Yeah. All right, let's go.
So you have Tolly Kaminsky, the trainer. He's throwing back these balls, these weights. You got balls flying over here. .29-3 Russian heavyweight. He told me he wants to fight Anthony Joshua. David, how many times do you push the car back and forth?
Four times and four times back.
Is that the most difficult thing to do today?
Say about that, yeah.
It's not easy.
Definitely not.
How does your dad come up with all these drills? Does he make them up himself? Is he just the original innovator?
He puts shit together. Makes a fucking war.
Huh?
Yes.
Okay. Next drill. I'm in Los Angeles in a park. They have a bunch of boxers. You hear Sergey Lipinets, he's going to be fighting for the IBF 140 title for his next fight. He's either going to fight that fighter from Africa, or if he vacates the belt, he's going to fight for the title against anybody. Sergey Lipinets, working hard, kickboxing champion. Sergey, how's the day at the park today?
What?
How's your day today? Good in the park?
Good, very good. Today is sparring around. Nice.
Yeah. До свидания.
До свидания.
All right, he's off to run more. He's fighting for the IBF title champion. He only has 11 pro fights, but he has sensational knockouts. Lipinets is very, very talented.
Disciplined, talented, strong. Mentally ready.
Crazy knockouts in his victories.
In this business, it's not enough to be good technique. It's not enough to be strong. You can be super strong. You have to be mentally. Mentally, if you're strong mentally, you have good future. A lot of fighters doesn't strong, no strong mentally.
Now, what can you tell us about the fighter that's pushing your car right now? 29-3, heavyweight from
this
Russia.
This is his record says himself. He's like a very disciplined fighter and very aggressive fighter. And mentally he's really strong. Look, he's all his family, included like his wife, his kids I don't know if he has kids or not, but wife and family live in Russia, and he him by himself here. Lipinets, his wife and his kid, his son in Russia, and you are part of the family, so it's really hard to stay. I trained some guy from Greek, and he just survived 1 week. He can't go back to country. He can't.
It's hard. Sacrifice. These Russian fighters sacrifice.
Oh, this.
He told me he wants to knock out Anthony Joshua. He says good night, Los Vidania, goodbye, easy work.
Like whatever he says, this is what he said.
Heavyweight division is back. That would be a big fight. Him and Joshua.
Exactly, Joshua. They have
Wilder, of course.
Wilder. They have Fury. If the Fury come back to the, we have Povetkin. I probably didn't know Povetkin. Difference.
Yeah.
But again,
what about Shannon Briggs? Him and Shannon Briggs. Do you
like
that fight?
Maybe Briggs and maybe the George Washington. They still.
Gerald Washington. Yeah. But they may train at the same gym, so.
No, they don't train in the same gym. They just sometimes they mix together.
Who does his boxing, Tolik? Who trains in boxing?
Who? Buddy McGirt.
Oh, but okay, same gym. Cause
yeah, Buddy McGirt. Yeah, but sometimes Washington, they do sparring all over.
Yeah. And one more time, his name for the people watching?
His name? Andrei Fedosov.
Andrei Fedosov from Russia.
No, he's very popular in it. I think he's really popular, pretty popular in boxing pool.
Okay. Someone is asking, can Gennady pull the upset? Gennady Golovkin, Canelo.
Gennady Golovkin, Canelo. Like I said today morning, like you come to the gym and I said, Golovkin, Gennady Golovkin, Canelo, I would say if Canelo not going to start move his legs, he's going to lose the fight. If Canelo going to stay in front of Golovkin, he's about to lose. If Golovkin going to make his defense better, of course he's going to win the fight. But if Canelo start move his legs, he's gonna win.
Okay, Tolik Kaminsky tells me the key to the Canelo winning this fight is his footwork.
Footwork only.
And
everything else he has himself.
Can the average person push your car back and forth, or do you have to be a super athlete, super strong, super?
It's
you every, be an athlete.
The car. Look, let me tell you, this car. No one part of from plastic. This
it's original
metal, 1948 Jeep. Stainless steel Jeep wheels. So everything built from the metal. It's super heavy duty.
And anybody who's watching this video or watching live, if they want to buy a Tolik, are you selling?
$20,000.
$20,000, a Jeep, that's good.
Right here, right now,
$20,000, all the way from the Terzana Park, California.
They want me to ask you about Mikey Broner. You told me it's a 50-50 fight, right? But you said
Mikey Garcia Broner 50-50. So far, in Broner make 140. If everything going to be fine, 140, so it's going to be 50-50 fight. And Mikey Garcia, it's not going to be easy fight. It's not going to be easy fight for Mikey. It's not going to be easy fight for Broner either.
But it's a very interesting fight. It's a very good fight.
Of course.
All right, Fernando. Shout out to Fernando Herrera. Where are you from, Fernando? Yeah. Aline, do you also push the car?
Yeah.
Is it hard?
Yeah, after him, I do so.
Shout out to Tengu's Boxing, repping their old school shirts right there.
Right? Still repping it.
Andrei Fedosov, very popular Russian heavyweight, putting in work. Van Nuys in the house.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Eli Sekpak reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Sekpak, and you can follow me on Instagram at Eli Sekpak.